we have here is Justin's about elbow deep digging for his shoe in the bog here. We could come over here. Oh, he found it. All right. So this, right at this point in time, Justin is questioning whether or not he should have came hunting this morning. You know.
About to go barefooted.
He's about to die.
Let's go camping, he said.
We'll just stay at.
Huh? I said, I'm still in pretty good shape over here.
I hit a bad hole again.
Good morning. It's a hog over here going crazy. It's about 7 o'clock, October 8th. Me and Darren and Justin all came to the same piece of pullet about an hour from the house. Walked in together. Darren split off about 3/4 mile back, and Justin another 1/2 mile. They went and set up. I came across the swamp and got up here on the hill where it opens up just a little. I'm gonna cut down the edge here for about 1.5 miles, and then I gotta go about 750 yards out across the swamp to an island. So I was kind of just taking my time easing up this edge, letting it get light, because it's hard to do. I don't know that I could hit the trail just right in the dark. I've only been in there one time. I'm gonna keep easing up this edge. I got my lock-on bag with me. That's the first time I've carried all the camera stuff and my stand this far. It's heavy. It's gonna, when I did the line distance on Onyx and figured it round trip, it was just over 8 miles. I'm just taking a little break right now. I'm gonna head on in. Should be a good day. Pressure's rising good till about 9 o'clock. And then the moon, full moon, so the moon's underfoot in the middle of the day. That's why I wasn't in a big hurry to get in there at daylight. As long as I get in there before 9 o'clock, I'm fine with that. I've been seeing the bucks just started making sign. I don't know, about the 3rd, so about 5 days ago. And there's, I've walked through plenty of fresh grapes coming up this edge. They're in here.
I just got done with that open interview, came a few yards, there was
bunch of hogs right there. I think it's loud enough to see them, okay? I'm easing up, but there ain't shooting a hog in there. Make sure they're up feeding. Some elusive creatures right there. This little doe I slipped up on it. I think I got it on camera before it ran off. About 3/4 grown. I've been standing about 5 yards behind me for 10 minutes because it was 6 or 8 longbeards out here. I let them go on off, turn the camera on. And 2 deer just took off for there about 80 yards. I never even knew they were there. I couldn't tell what they were, just flagged off. That's fine, nope. This is where I'm gonna cut back in the swamp. So if I bump anything, they ought to just bump on back now towards where I'm wanting to sit anyway. There's some turkeys again. I got a camera up here on the edge at home. I don't even remember now. 2 months ago, probably. I don't know, it's been a while. I checked it one time. It was actually open in the morning, so September 17th, but there wasn't much on it. It might have been one little buck, I don't remember. But I saw two groups of bucks in here in small game when I was scouting. And the camera's not on anything. I just put it where I saw the bucks, or the direction where they were standing. I'm gonna slip up here and check it. Hopefully not bugger too many more deer. I think those there were just feeding on acorns, what it looks like out here on this. This is a higher ridge on the edge of the swamp. There's another turkey right here. could see that or not. I just got the GoPro in my hand. My hands are kind of full, the other camera's around my neck. Somebody got a cow out over here. A little curious. Oh, I think I got a deer right here. I saw something move. I'm not sure what it was. Oh, it's just a hog. Need to just be still and quit scaring stuff. I'm about 900 yards from where I'm wanting to sit, so I'm gonna ease on up, I guess. See what's on that camera. Up here to the camera. I think there's deer I just saw. We're going to be behind the camera, so I probably don't have a picture of them. I don't know what they were. Just check the camera. There was a pile of deer on it, but the only buck was a little goofy one-sided thing. I knew it was gonna be hard to get a picture up here, and I didn't want to. I scouted him out, and that's where I'm headed in there to sit, where I think he spends most of his daylight time. But I kind of just wanted a picture out here, but I'll probably hang a camera in there where I sit and just leave it. If nothing else, I'll come back out here gun season. If I don't make it back in bow season, then check it. I'm gonna head on in. It's a little after 8 o'clock, so I'm running a little behind. Keep watching these hogs and turkeys. So I'm about to have pigs there. I done got iron got hot. I just came up on the first ridge out here in the middle of the swamp. I'm still 150 yards or so from where I want to go. There's a little bit of feeding sign here on acorns, but not much. I just came up on the tip of the ridge. I haven't seen nothing yet. Show you what I'm talking about. I don't know if you can see it or not, but them trees right there are hooked. Those trees are hooked. It's hard to get higher, but it's pretty high. I'm sure I'm close to a buck now. The wind's kind of coming almost straight out of the north. I swung farther south. That way I can walk into the wind real slow. I'm gonna get up here and get set up somewhere. Hopefully not bump nothing. Sit here through the middle of the day because I'm about wore out. Rest my legs and rest my back. And then probably start easing back towards where the fresh buck sign is for the evening if I haven't seen nothing. I did have a deer come by about 80 yards when I was unpacking. Just traveling, I couldn't tell what it was. I was just glimpsing it. I heard it step in the water. It was out on the edges. It's sticky in there. That's kind of the end of the hill where it slopes back down into the swamp over there about 80 yards. Ain't a lot of shooting. Give it a little while, never know. Eat me a snack, drink some water. Darren said he's about to head out. And I think Justin's only seen a doe, so it ain't been too good anywhere. Moon ought to be about underfoot now, I guess. We'll see. It's 12:15. The wind's kind of swirling. I haven't seen nothing. Didn't really figure I would. Sit up here and eat some beanie weenies and some sardines. I'm ready to go again now. Huh? I'm gonna go ahead and pack up and get done. And start heading back towards the hill. I was sure hoping he was gonna be in here on this island, but there ain't no sign of him. There's a turkey. See if I can video it. I don't think I ever got her on camera. I just sat here and watched her for no more than 15 minutes. She came all the way up here. Stayed behind the cabbage pond. Couldn't ever see her again. Anyway, I'm fixing to pack it up and relocate for the evening. At least it'll be a whole lot easier to walk out of here at dark. I think I'm just gonna have to get lucky to get air on one of these out here. They don't do the same thing often enough. They're all over the place. Oh well, at least there's some big ones out here. I'm gonna pack it up. Came up out of the water there. And this buck's got this hooked fresh. I was shaving just still on top of the lead. See one's laid right there. Ain't been in the past few days. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to make it across this mess or not. It's about a jungle wire. That hooking's right there. And I just pointed to the bed. I just hopped across here to the next little hill. It's hard to see. That bed right there is going to use fresh with the other one. This one here still got wet mud in it. What do you got up there? Or the deer, buck or doe, whatever it is. Pretty good sized bed doing with that hooking. I would say it's a buck. I don't know how in the world I'd hunt him. It's a rough place. what you could see. I just been standing there for a second because I actually went around this bog right here the wrong way. I was supposed to be on the other side of that root ball over there, about 60 yards. And I just heard something coming to me and squatted down. I couldn't see him until he got 20 yards right there. Just laying here kind of snoozing with Justin. We met up for lunch here and heard something coming. Check out this bad boy. That's a close look I'm gonna get. Nasty creature. What is she, about 5.5 feet long? From a big diamond back to a coral snake. Pretty good one. Well, I'm done filming snakes. Maybe. It's 4:30. I met up with Justin. We took a couple hour break in the middle. In the middle of the day. I don't have a lot of confidence here. I'm gonna sit on the ground. And there's a trail with a lot of hooking on it that runs down the side of this pond. It's a big open pond. It's a big open pond out here. And the trail just comes off the point, comes down through it. It's kind of tucked here in the shade. Should be some acorns falling back over here, but I didn't want to walk over there. I don't have a lot of confidence, but I didn't feel like climbing that tree again. I'll sit here till dark and see what happens. When I was in here in small game, I took pictures of a pretty nice little 6-point up here on the point of this pond, bedded down. And me and Justin just found a shed. We were walking. We were coming up here. That I think is. It was 3 of them bucks that day. But anyway, I'm gonna sit here and be quiet. 6:35. I can hear for a long way, so I just want to kick back relaxing. I haven't seen anything. Not even a squirrel. Got about 50 minutes left to shoot a lot, I think. I'm gonna set it out. I know I'm hungry. Fat boy doesn't eat much today. Maybe I have about 10 to 15 more minutes where I can shoot, but that's about it. I'll slowly pack this junk up and get my lights out. Start getting cameras put up and all that junk. I can hear for a long way, so I don't think nothing will sneak up on me. I guess overall it's been a decent day. I guess any day when you could kill one with a bow was a decent day. Saw plenty of hogs. Need a cold front or something. These bucks just ain't doing nothing. But anyway, I'm gonna pack this junk up and start getting out of here.